Welcome Bitcoin friends, Bitcoin Mamo. So we're going to look at the Bitcoin charts, we'll do some TA, look at various time frames, and we'll also take a look at Market Cipher. We are coming in towards the monthly close, which is also the quarterly close. Look at some key levels, and the three things that I'll need to see for me to go macro bullish. That we are still in a bull market and looking for new all-time highs. So if that sounds interesting, stay tuned. Let's get into the charts. So we are starting here on the monthly time frame. We are only a few days away from that monthly close, and at the moment it is looking quite good with this recent pump to the upside. We do see Bitcoin is currently above this trend line connecting these two lows, and is also above this golden pocket area looking at the retracement level from the 29k low to the 69k high. And we're also watching this order block in blue here. This order block comes from this red candle in an uptrend. It's an area of supply and demand and becomes of interest later on when we interact with that level and can act as support or resistance. So we'll have to see how this monthly candle closes. To close above this order block, we would need to close above 47,124. And looking at the 3 month chart now, it does look quite different. We can see we obviously had this big drawdown in April, and then we did have this huge wick to the upside, but we did end up closing that quarter and the end of the year at 46,000. And this current quarterly candle did wick all the way down to 32,000 here and has been brought back up to around 47,000. So when looking at the 3 month time frame here, it does seem that Bitcoin's fair price seems to be around this level, around the mid 40,000 area. Obviously we went much higher and we went much lower, but we have reverted back to this mean. If we do close above 46,000, this would be the third quarter in a row that we have had green candles. And it is interesting, even looking at the 2 month chart, there is another month on this candle still, but looking at the 2 month chart and the Fib levels, taking it from this low to this high, and looking at the retracement with the 2 month time frame, we never actually closed below this golden pocket area. And down to the 2 week time frame now, we did just open this new 2 week candle. We did have this strong close all the way up at 46,700 approximately. And we can see we did close inside this order block here. And there's also another order block inside here from this green candle in this downtrend. So we did close inside both of these order blocks here. And we could spend a bit of time inside this order block. This red order block here is that monthly order block. And if we are able to start closing above this 2 week order block, above 48,700 approximately, then I would expect higher prices and I'd be looking for this order block from this red candle in this uptrend, which is between 55,000 and 59,000. But we would need to see Bitcoin get above this order block, perhaps come back down to retest it for support, and also this major trend line connecting the lows here. And if we did bounce off that trend line, then I would target this next higher order block from this red candle in this uptrend, which is between 55,000 and 59,000 approximately. And pulling up the VPVR now, this is the amount of volume traded at certain price levels. We do see a big spike here, pretty much where we are, at around 47,500 to 48,000. And this could possibly act as resistance. Again, if we are able to get above this order block, we would also get above this spike of volume, and on a pullback, look for it to act as support, and also this order block and this trend line, and then look for the higher prices in this order block, which lines up with the next biggest spike on the VPVR around 57,000. Looking at the stochastic RSI, we are seeing it starting to tick up here. We do still have a week and a half on this candle before it closes, but it would be bullish if Bitcoin closes above this white dotted line above the 20 level. But I want to pay more attention to the RSI here on the 2 week time frame, and I've just got a blue box marked out here. can see it's acted as support here. This is between 46 and 47 reading. And I think this is important when looking at the past here. And I've just got marked out here the times that we broke below this level and spent time below it. And then when we did regain it, we can see this has marked out bear markets. Also the stock market crash here. We can see on this drop down, we dropped below this level on the RSI. And once we did reclaim it, we continued on the way back up. This was more of a black swan event, and the other ones are more relevant to the bottoms of bear markets. So we can see here, we did bounce off this line a few times as we did get these dead cat bounces. But once we broke below that level, did initiate the bottom of the bear market range here. Just to show that a bit closer, we can see it acted as support and we spent time below it at the bottom of the bear market. Going back to the previous bear market now in 2014, 2015, we see a similar thing. Once we did break below this level on the RSI, we continued lower and this was the bottom of the bear market here. Once we did reclaim that area, we really started off on the bull run. So we can see below this level on the RSI between 46 and 47 on the 2 week time frame. These were really great buying opportunities at the bottom of the bear market. And we do have one more going all the way back to the 2011 bear market. We see we dropped below that level on the RSI, and this also marked out the bottom of the bear market and a great buying opportunity. Relating that to our current price action, we can see on this dip down here and consolidation, we pretty much held the 37.7K level. And on the RSI, we can see we bounced off this level a couple of times. So that is more of a bullish sign. If we do break below this level on the RSI, we could see something similar to the previous bear markets. We have one final big capitulation and spend time at the bottom of the bear market. And going down to the weekly time frame now, we can see we did close above this trend line connecting these lows. We did reclaim that level, also reclaim the golden pocket area. And just looking at some weekly order blocks here, we did close inside this order block coming from this green candle in a downtrend. Currently we are above that order block, but we have to wait for the week to close to see if we can close above this order block. Above that, there is two more order blocks from this green candle and from this red candle. And these order blocks are between 48.9K and 50,000 approximately. These are those 2 week order blocks in yellow. It will be interesting to see if Bitcoin can get above all of these order blocks and have a bit of clear air here. We can see previously, once we got above these levels, we have had some big moves on these candles. And again, looking at the 2018 bear market, these weekly order blocks were important. We saw that each of these order blocks marked the top of the dead cat bounces. Looking at the weekly EMA ribbon now, we did close back above this EMA ribbon, with the top of the ribbon being at 44.8K. And one of the things I need to see for me to flip macro bullish here is for us to spend a whole week above this ribbon, including the wicks, without touching this ribbon at all. And one of the other things I needed to see to turn macro bullish was to close above this 50-week moving average, which we did on this candle. We were watching this 50-day moving average, as in the previous bear market. Once we lost it here in 2018, we came back up, got resistance, and then we didn't reclaim it until we restarted the bull market after the bottom of the bear market. So we have done something different here. We have managed to close above it on the current cycle. Looking back at the 2014 bear market, once we lost that 50-week moving average, we didn't even test it here on these dead cat bounces. We got resistance once down here. Once we broke it, we continued the bull run. One of the other things I'm looking for to turn macro bullish here is for us to get above this blue box on the RSI. This is between a 50 and a 56 reading approximately. And this has been significant when looking at the previous price action. We can see we did lose it here during this drop. We reclaimed it, came back, tested it for support on this pullback, acted as support, and then we moved it much higher. And also in the initial bull run here, we tested it for support several times and we stayed above it. And then we did start that bull run. We also did a similar thing in the 2016-2017 bull run. We used this level as support all the way up. And then in the 2018 bear market, we used it as resistance all the way down. So this is definitely a key area on the RSI I'm watching on the weekly time frame. And if we are able to get back above it, I would turn macro bullish along with those other signs we talked about. We could come back and test it for support. Obviously, if we lost it again, I would lose that macro bullishness. But if it did act as support and went back above the area, that would confirm this level as support. And perhaps we do a similar thing like on this pullback. But we are pretty much inside this box at the moment. And this may take a couple of weeks to play out. The stochastic RSI looks quite good here. Things are looking quite bullish. We are ticking some of the boxes here to turn macro bullish. And down to the 5-day time frame now. We've been watching a lot of these order blocks as they have been significant. We can see we're currently in this order block from this red candle in the uptrend. This order block's between 44,800 and 47,800. We will open a new 5-day candle at the start of next month. So again, we'll be looking to close above this order block, above 47,800. There is another thin order block here at 49K. And above that, the next order block isn't until 54K. You do also see a possible channel here that we may be in, just connecting the lows here and these highs. We did wick above it briefly, but currently we are trading below it. So this could possibly act as resistance and we might see a pullback. And looking at some fibs also on this previous drop here from 65K down to 29K. We saw the bounce go all the way up to the golden pocket here. This is where we got that decent pullback. And looking at our current price action in the fib retracement from the 69K high to the 33K low, you can see we're currently above the 382 level at 46.7K. If we are able to get above this channel, we could possibly target the 0.5 fib level at 51K. Each of these levels are possible turnaround points. If we were able to get all the way to the golden pocket, that would be between 55K and 56K. And also in line with this 5-day order block from this green candle in this downtrend. So what did we do in the past bear market here on these dead cat bounces? We can see on the initial big drop here, this dead cat bounce came up to the 382 level. And then we did get rejected and go back down. Obviously, this was a blow off top and we haven't experienced that with our current market. So things could be different. So just looking at these other dead cat bounces here on this drop from here down to here, we saw we had a dead cat bounce and we came exactly to that golden pocket area. The next drop from here down to here, we also came exactly to that golden pocket area. And this drop from here to here, we didn't quite touch that golden pocket area, but got pretty close here, only about $80 off. So quite often that golden pocket area is where we will get resistance. We do also need to watch the 382 level and the 0.5 level. The 2014 bear market now, we can see on this drop after this bounce from here down to here, we had a dead cat bounce up to that 0.5 level, and that was the resistance area. So it's just good to look at those past bear markets to try to get an idea if this is a dead cat bounce or we're going to continue and push for new all-time highs. And down to the daily time frame now, I have just marked off a few order blocks here. There are quite a lot of order blocks. It does get quite messy marking them all off. I've just marked off some that I think are the key ones here. And basically, I'm looking at when there's a strong trend like this, and we get a red candle slowing that trend, showing there's buyers and sellers here and indecision. So I think this is a key order block. and also this order block from this strong uptrend with a red candle, and finally this order block here from this uptrend with this red candle. Just looking at those three order blocks, we can see this one was quite significant, acting as resistance here. Currently we are testing this higher order block between 47.6k and 48.2k, and that next one higher up is at 48.6k to 48.9k. Did have this channel drawn the same as on that 5-day chart, and I've also just marked off this dotted line connecting these two highs, as I think if we do get a rejection at the top of this trend line, we possibly come back and test this trend line and try to flip it into support. This would also be in line with this order block and also the previous resistance levels on these attempts higher. So flipping previous resistance into support would be bullish. And we also have the 382 fib level, taking it from this low to this high. So there is some confluence between all these levels. And we also see, just looking at this recent price action here, we also have a spike on the VPVR, where we currently are around 47,500. So this could act as resistance. We might get pulled back, flip this trend line into support, and also get support on this order block and the 382 level and the VPVR support. So we're also watching to see if we can break this 200-day moving average in red. The 50-day moving average is in yellow here, and currently we have gotten a bit of resistance here at this 200-day moving average. And this is the other thing I'm looking for to turn macro bullish, is to get above the 200-day moving average and spend at least a week above it. And if we are able to do that, eventually we'll see a golden cross here with the yellow crossing the red, as we did on this occasion, and that did initiate higher prices. And we're looking for that 200-day moving average, because in the 2018 bear market, after getting that death cross with the yellow going below the red, the 200-day moving average was our resistance level on these dead cat bounces. So we're also watching the daily EMA ribbon here, which acted as resistance all the way down. We were looking for this ribbon to flip, and we have done that. The yellow moving average is at the top of the ribbon now. We mentioned in previous videos, once this happens on pullbacks, the top of this ribbon quite often acts as support and is a good entry into a long position. As we see after this drop and we broke the ribbon, it flipped bullish. On the pullback, it acted as support and we moved higher. We do see this ribbon will eventually come in line with this order block and that 382 level and this white trend line. So perhaps on a pullback here, we could look for this to act as support. And quickly looking at the Bitcoin futures chart now, we did make a gap here upon the weekly open. We can see we have this gap. Quite often we do come back to fill these gaps like we did on this occasion and this occasion. This one did take about 8 or 9 days to come back to fill that gap. So we could look for on a pullback to fill this gap. The gap goes down to 45,400. It doesn't have to get filled straight away. We could go a lot higher and eventually come back and fill that gap. But it is something we need to pay attention to. I do have this red box here, as on the futures chart and the VPVR, we do see a big spike where our current price action is. And this red box just marks off that area of the VPVR possible resistance. It might be a bit hard to see, but we can see we're currently in this biggest spike. We do also see that when just looking at the volume profile over the shorter time range, we do see that spike where our current price is. And just quickly looking at Market Cipher now, this is the daily time frame. We were in the red money flow here, meaning money is leaving the market for quite a long time here. And we did cross into the green around this area, and it is looking quite good. The money flow is still coming up. This blue wave is still coming up. We don't have a red dot yet on the daily time frame. And the last time we saw this happen after this consolidation, we flipped into the green money flow around here and did initiate higher prices. Looking at the weekly time frame now, we can see this blue wave starting to come up. If we can cross this zero line here with this blue wave, that would be more bullish. The money flow was going close to going into the red here, and it has just ticked up. So we do need to see that continue. The 2-week time frame is looking very good here. We have managed to get this green dot, but it will take another week and a half for that to be confirmed. And the last green dot we had below the zero line here was back here after the stock market crash recovery and did initiate the bull run. Looking back at the 2018 bear market though, we did get a green dot confirmed on this dead cat bounce, and the following 2-week candle got the red dot, which did initiate further downside. So it's not guaranteed. Obviously, we have to remain bullish on it. We have to wait for it to get confirmed. If it does get confirmed, we take it as a bullish sign until we see a red dot, and then we can be more cautious. We saw a similar thing here in the 2014 bear market. We did get a green dot on the 2-week time frame, and then 4 weeks later, we got that red dot. So we can be bullish on the green dot. We did move to the upside. Once we got that red dot, we had to be cautious and look for lower prices. And finally, even the 3-week time frame does have a green dot now. We'll have to wait 2.5 weeks for that to get confirmed. We don't see them very often. We did get one here also after the stock market crash. But looking back at the 2018 bear market, we didn't get any green dots until the bottom of the bear market. Also looking back at the 2014 bear market, we didn't get a green dot also until the bottom of the bear market. So these don't have to be the same, but it is quite interesting if that green dot does get confirmed. On the previous two occasions, it has indicated the bottom of the bear market. Obviously, this blue wave isn't as deep, but again, we have to take it as a bullish sign if it does get confirmed in 2.5 weeks. So things are looking quite good on Market Cipher on the macro time frame. And again, I'll go over those things I need to see for me to turn macro bullish. So first, I'd like to see Bitcoin close above this 2-week order block above 48,700. Second, on the weekly time frame now, I want to see Bitcoin close above this area on the RSI between 50 and 56 level. I want to see a weekly close with the RSI above this. I also need to see Bitcoin spend a whole week here above this weekly EMA ribbon without touching it with any of the wicks. The top of the ribbons at 44,820. And finally, I need to see Bitcoin get above the 200-day moving average here in red and spend some time above it. But if we are above the 200-day moving average and we tick the box on those other things I mentioned, then I would turn macro bullish and look for higher prices towards 55, 60,000 area. So I think that's about all. We covered a lot in this video. Hope you enjoyed that analysis. I'm Bitcoin Mammo. I'll see you next time. Bye.